Welcome to the Museum of Bad Taste. Come with me. The idea of the Museum of Bad Taste actually got its start with this particularly hideous piece. I was in the lower quarter one time, I'm going to say 20 years ago, and I had a lot of this stuff kind of in the back of my head, and I wanted something that was like the most hideous place in the French Quarter. Well, what a good place to start. This is a harlequin spinning. Now, what could be uglier than that? And it started here, and it's been downhill ever since. For example, right here is a cigarette machine. Now, this isn't just any cigarette machine. This was Helen Mirren's cigarette machine. It all works, only I filled it up with candy cigarettes. How tasteless is that? If you come over here, here is where I work and I get my hair done at the same time. Look at this, speaking of tasteless. It is my hair dryer. And as I said, it works. So I can sit, do my work here while I sit and get my hair done. And oftentimes I will read movie magazines. Let's shake things up a little bit and go back here behind the bar and see what's cooking or what I can stir up some trouble-wise. And if you look here, well, here is a cocktail shaker. Talking about shaking things up. This is an old one, silver one from the 50s that shakes, that looks like a rocket ship. Now, how tacky is that? But I've got something even worse in mind if you want to take a look at this. If I don't have a martini ready for you, I can always go in and go to my library and voila! What you're looking at right now is something truly tasteless, but I think it's truly historic. And this is my prophylactic machine, and not just any kind of rubber machine that you used to see in all the service station restrooms from the 60s or whatnot. This one came from Tipitina's. And you see right now, I've got 50 cents. And I just like to think of how many people doesn't quite turn still. Oh, it does. God, it's been so long since I used it. Here's my little kitchen. I turn out food here for 50 to 100 people as I entertain quite frequently. So anyway, come on through and follow me. Follow me. There's more. Ta-da! You thought you'd seen it all, but you hadn't seen anything yet. Because look at here, you're in my bedroom now. Talk about that. It's just as tasteless as the rest of it. This bed is done in my cowboy motif with 50s cowboys down here and on the sheets, and look up above it is an inflatable deer head. And of course it is inflatable because no animals were harmed in the making of this documentary. And here we come to my latest acquisition. It's these cattail lamps. I found them way down at the end of the quarter. And I saw them, and they were tucked away way back, like the people were embarrassed about them. But I got those for $15 each. But what a steal. And it went so well with my tacky little TV light. You've seen these before. That's reminiscent of a TV right there. Then you've got this horrible, tasteless plaster art that looks like it came out of a fair or a carnival midway somewhere. And I thought, look, what a great way to really focus on something hideous with these cattail lamps. And if you look up here, this thing weighs a ton. It's Murano glass. And I love it, even though it's not lit up right now for a good reason. But it kind of matches all the gaudy fruit that you see right there in that old carnival art. How about this? A poodle lamp, a pink poodle lamp that I've combined with Barbie doll collection here with Superman and a Prince Albert smoking tobacco ad. Talk about tasteless. This is the epitome of the Museum of Bad Taste. What would a balcony be in the French Quarter without having the very best, most tasteful one around. Come with me and you'll see. Come on. This is one of the most historic buildings in the French Quarter. That is called the skyscraper of the French Quarter. Built in the year 1800, it was originally three stories, and they added that fourth story on it because they thought that if that was a test to see if they could go up that high and it didn't sink in the mud, then it was safe to go up four stories. And here it stands today. And right next to it, down this way, is where Tennessee Williams wrote Streetcar Named Desire, right here. And right across the street over here is where William Faulkner wrote Soldier's Pay and Truman Capote wrote Answered Prayers. So we're just surrounded by literary history, architecture, and other things of fine taste. Since the very beginning of a Museum of Bad Taste, one of the most important pieces or parts of it has been the lamp collection. For example, this hula lamp, which is not really tasteless, but I love it. Including, if you look at this, this one is pretty tasteless. Someone gave that to me. And the little hula girls, too, that dance with it. So it all kind of fits together just terribly tackly. We talked about this one a little bit earlier. This is an atomic lamp, if you look, with the solar system here. And if you get down a little bit lower, you see those rings like the rings of Saturn. You would not think that this is tasteless, but it is. These lamps suggest the curves of a woman. Those are from the 60s or maybe the 70s, but it's, this is a Andrew Bucci painting from Mississippi, and I think it all just accentuates perfectly, especially with this old Skyliner clock that goes with it. But I think the least tasteful thing is right here, because this is a wooden leg from the Civil War. Talk about tasteless. If you look at this, it gives me the creeps. So I put it as far away from my bedroom and every place else that I could. It's this wooden leg from the Civil War. Talk about tasteless. This is the epitome of it. So over and out.